What's up, guys? It's Nate with FreedomVanGo. Today I'm working on this Spreco doing a DC-DC install. Let's get right into it. So this is the Victron Energy Orion XS 50 amp DC to DC charger. So it's going to take the 12 volt DC off of the Mercedes Sprinter battery, and it's going to charge the house system, which is also 12 volt DC, with 50 amps of charge. So it's a really reliable charger, charges 50 amps at idle and while you're driving. Very consistent charge that functions independently of all of the other charging systems. So all together, once the engine's running, it's a very, very fast charge. So I've already begun installing a little bit. All that was really done was this faceplate comes out. You can hang all the fuses and everything down here out of the way. I went ahead and did some compartment cleanup, made sure all the wires are straight, everything was good to go, and that I had room to run my wires through. So we're gonna start basically by mounting the unit. I picked this spot right here, it's out of the way. Very simple, it's just two screws to hold it down. If you can get back in here, there are another two screws, but you know, two screws seem to hold it down just fine. And then we have these two wires, which are actually going to connect to the bus bars right here in the system. And then we have this wire on the input side, which needs to connect to the Mercedes battery. So I like to run that back and out of the way as much as possible. In a minute, we're going to be drilling a hole so that it can pass through the compartment and out to where the vehicle battery is. But first, let's go ahead and hook these up. So we have the in the compartment connections done. We have the output positive going to the top post here, which was empty. So now it's gonna charge the house positive. Same thing with the negative. We're gonna run that down and back here. And then we ground it here to the ground bus bar. So that's two out of three connections. All that's left is to run the input. So that's gonna go to the Mercedes Sprinter battery. So I already have it tucked up behind everything and coming out here. Next, what we're gonna do is go outside the compartment and drill a hole for this to pass through. So let's get into it. Getting ready to drill our hole. I got a half inch drill bit. Seems to work the best if we're just passing the DC-DC wire through. And what I like to do is feel around on the inside to kind of get a gauge for where everything's mounted. And then I'll pick a spot that's close to this existing pass through. And I'm gonna drill through nice and slow, nice and easy. There are no wires in the way, but you know, just in case I miscalculated or anything like that, still gonna go really slow just to make sure that we don't puncture or cut any wires. So let's do it. All right, so we have our pass-through hole drilled now just underneath the pass-through right here. So all that's left is for me to grab some paint. We're gonna paint this hole to make sure that it does not rust because it is behind the driver wheel and water will splash on it. So we're gonna paint this real quick. I'm gonna go ahead and remove this fuse portion so that it's just this terminal passing through. Makes it much easier for wire runs. And then you don't have to figure out something that's big enough for this. So we're gonna take this off. We're gonna feed it through and we'll keep rolling. Now the idea here is obviously to pass this outside of the compartment. You know, there's multiple ways to skin a cat. If you decide you want to do a larger pass-through hole, especially if you're doing other upgrades like lighting or any other power system upgrades that would necessitate the use of a pass-through, you can do a bigger hole and not have to take this apart. It's completely up to you. But you know, for this application, I'm opting for the smaller hole and we're just gonna pass this through. So a little tech tip, if you're wanting to pass this through a hole, since I'm using a really, really small hole and they don't make grommets that small, what I like to do is use either a piece of heat shrink, electrical tape, or a combination of both. And what I'm gonna do is pass this wire through, and wherever the wire that goes through the compartment ends up being, it'll probably be a section about that long, I'll put this heat shrink there and shrink it down, wrap it up with a little bit of electrical tape, you know, whatever you wanna do, but protect this wire since it does not have a sheath on it. And that'll help when, you know, the wind's blowing or there's any sort of movement underneath the coach, you want to make sure that this wire is stabilized and that it's protected from chafe. So heat shrink is my tool of choice there, but it is up to you. I highly recommend that you protect this wire some way. Oh,
see my hole.
Now we're going to start running this up to the vehicle battery. Our target's right here next to the transfer case. There's a little plastic cover, and there's two positive studs that are poking down. We're going to shoot for the lower one. So we're going to follow the factory wires that run through here, jump across when necessary, and secure with plenty of zip ties. So we've got our positive in connected here on the lower post. I just like to splay it over to the right just a hair. This cover will snap back on, but you do have to do a little bit of extra trimming since this is pushed over slightly and this is here now, was not before. So what I'll do is just take a little razor knife and cut up and over, and then take a small chunk up to here. Just kind of follow this, you know, little tab here straight up until you get to the logo, and then go straight down and then across. Now we got a nice little relief cut. This tab is still here, and then we have enough room for the terminal. Let's push up on those two tabs, make sure it's locked in, and then push these, and you're good to go. Everything's still covered here. You got enough room for this terminal. You got enough room for this guy here too. I'm just gonna throw a couple more zip ties, kind of provide a little bit of strain relief here. Just work my way back and trim all the zip ties I already have. So that pretty much wraps up the basics for our DC-DC install. If you're looking to get the part for yourself, be sure to check us out at vanpartswarehouse.com. Or if you're wanting to get one installed on your Spreco, be sure to check us out at freedomvango.com and get yourself on the schedule. This has been Nate with FreedomVanGo. Let us help you upgrade your adventure.